Hi guys, this is Jasmine with Jazzy Crafts and Cards. Let's see what we're making today. So today I have for you a kind of a watercolor background card that I've made. It says, wishing you brighter days to come, and it is a light up card. So there's a paper circuit in there allowing that to light up on the fairy's wand. So we're going to be making that today. Alright, let's look at what we need to make this card. I've got a variety of things here out on the work surface that you can see. We're going to start with this pile over here. So what I've got here is just regular 110-pound white cardstock that I've got folded into an A2 sized card base. Then I have a scrap piece of that same kind of cardstock. Then I've got two pieces of paper here that are this Canson watercolor paper that I have cut to one size that will go on top of our card base here, so that will be matted nicely. So this is, if the card base is 5.5 by 4.25, then this top mat that is the watercolor paper is 5.25 by 4. And then I just used a scrap of that watercolor paper and this curvy stitched die here that you can see to cut this out for a nice curvy background there. Okay, so we'll set those aside. This die is something that I got on eBay from China, so it does not really have a brand. But I believe Lawn Fawn creates some that are fairly similar. Okay, speaking of things on eBay from China, this stamp set here with these fairies, you can see them, is also something that I got on eBay from China, so it does not have a brand name. Then we'll be using this Inkadinkado set with the mason jars. And finally, as far as stamps go, I'll be using this Stampin Up Beautiful You set, simply for, which one? This sentiment here, which says, wishing you brighter days to come. Okay, I'm gonna set all those to the side. As far as inks go, I will be using Ranger Archival Black to stamp my images. I will be using Tim Holtz Distress Inks, Seedless Preserved, Chips Sapphire, and Mermaid Lagoon for the kind of sunset colored background here. And then I will be using Pine Needles and Mowed Lawn for the grassy background. I will also be using some foam tape as well as some foam squares that are pre-cut to pop up the background. As I said, this is a light up card, so I'll be using copper tape to form my paper circuit, as well as a coin cell battery. This happens to be Sony brand CR2016 lithium 3-volt battery. I also buy those on eBay for pretty cheap in a bundle of a bunch of them. Then I'll be using this kit of LED lights that I also got. Actually, I think I got these on Amazon, and I want to say maybe I got these batteries on Amazon too. But this is just an assortment of LEDs and that come in two sizes. Okay. Then some simpler things here. I've got some Spectrum Noir colors for the tip of her wand here. I'm going to be coloring that with Spectrum Noir markers. I've got FL3 and CT1 as the colors I'll be using. I've got a watercolor brush here, some scissors, my ATG gun, my homemade stamp tool, and you can see it's already got my sentiment from that Stampin' Up set in there. And this here at the top of the screen, if you watch some of my other videos, you'll know that this is just a piece of packaging from something. I don't remember what it's from, but I use it as a palette for my watercolor, watercoloring with this Distress Inks. So that'll be at the top of my screen here. Okay, I think that's all. Let me zoom us in and we'll get started. Okay, as usual, guys, I forgot to mention something that I'll be using, which is just a water mister. I don't think this has a brand. I just got it pretty cheap. Just filled with regular tap water, and I'm going to use it to mist the watercolors on my mat here. Okay, so all I need right now is the blue and purple distress inks and my water mister, and then the 5 1/4 by 4 size sheet of watercolor paper. I am going to just kind of randomly place these colors out on my work surface here. You will not be able to see them on camera, I don't believe, but I can see them okay from here. So I'm going to start with my chipped sapphire, and I'm just going to place some of this out on my nonstick mat here, kind of randomly. Then I'm going to move to my Mermaid Lagoon, and looking in between those spots where I placed that ink, I'm just going to place some of this Mermaid Lagoon. Again, just kind of randomly. And then I'm going to go in and fill in some spots with this Seedless Preserves. Okay. So I've got a pretty large area here that's got ink on it. I'm going to move everything out of the way because I'm going to mist with water. So just kind of all over that area. Now I will say, on the sample that I made right here, I did not use watercolor paper for this, so you can do it just on regular white cardstock. It just makes it, it's a little harder to do because the water doesn't hold as much, or the paper doesn't hold as much water, and so you have to dry it more often to not get it to really tear up the fibers of the paper. So that's why on this one I'm actually going ahead and using the watercolor paper. So I'm giving this quite a bit of water here now that I'm using the watercolor paper because it can handle it. And I think now that I've sprayed that, it shows up on the camera quite a bit better. So you can probably see. Okay, if you don't use watercolor paper, you might not know. There are kind of two different sides. One of them is a pretty smooth surface and the other side is has more texture to it. That's the side that you want to use, is the textured side. So I'm going to use that textured side and I'm just going to kind of dip it down into that wet ink that I've got. And I'm not worried about covering all the spaces right now. That is good enough for me. Can you see it? There we go. That's good enough for me right now because I'm going to go in with my heat tool, which I didn't say you needed. So yes, you'll also need a heat tool. I'm going to go in with that and just kind of dry this a little bit, and then we'll pick up more of that color. You might also need a paper towel in case there's any drips. I'm not going to worry about flipping this over and applying that heat to the backside to fix that warp yet. I'm not even drying it totally. I'm drying it enough that it can go in and pick up more liquid without being totally saturated. So I'm going to try to focus some of this ink in those white areas now, just so that they get covered. Again, that's fine with me for now because we can always go and pick up more color as we need it. So I'm going to dry that again. Okay, and so this is what we're looking like now. I'm going to go in and add even more color. Again, trying to focus on some of these white areas that I've got here, just so I get full coverage. And I'm going to dry it again. I think you guys are getting quite a bit of shine from my light. I'm wondering if I can fix that a little for you. I notice you can't really see that color too well unless I bring it way up here. So that's what we look like right now. I'm still not totally happy with that, so I'm going to go ahead and pick up the rest of the ink that's on my work surface, and then I may lay down some more ink. Okay. So that's what we've got, guys, for our kind of a sunset background there. Not bad. Pretty nice. Okay. So I'm going to set that to the side. And we can go ahead and put away those purple and blue colors of our distress inks. We're done with those. And I'm going to pull out my green colors, which I've got pine needles and mowed lawn. I'm going to do the same thing here. Just a couple small spots of pine needles, and I really like the lightness of the mowed lawn, I think, better. So I'm going to use more of that. Okay. Okay, spray it again with water. Now, like I said, this is a stitched, I don't know if you can see that at all. My light is terrible right now. It's a stitched edge on this, so it looks different on the back. It's not quite as stitched, so I'm going to use the stitched side, which is also the more textured side of that watercolor cardstock. I'm just going to dip it in here, pick up that color, and that's all I got to start with, and that's fine. I'm going to dry that on and add more layers. Alright, I've done several passes. I kind of quickened that up so you didn't have to watch the whole thing again. This is where we're at with the grass. It's kind of splotchy right now. I kind of think that's neat. Let's see what it looks like with the background to see if we want to leave it. And you'll notice this is bigger than the background, and that's intentional for right now because I'm not sure where I want that hill to land on the page. So I cut it bigger, that way I can trim it down however I want to as I get there. So together, that's kind of what it's going to look like right now. I think just because I've got a little bit of ink still left down on my mat that I'm going to go ahead and pick up a little bit more color, and what we end up with is what we'll go with. Okay. Okay. So this is what we're left with. I think that looks really neat. Okay. So now I'm going to set those to the side. Like I said, I'm going to clean up my work surface. I'm going to bring out my scrap piece of white cardstock, my Inkadinkado mason jar stamps, and my fairy stamps here, as well as my homemade stamp tool. Like I said, I had that sentiment on there. I'm going to go ahead and take it off and we'll put it back on when we need it. Because right now I'm going to stamp this scrap piece of white cardstock. I'm just going to stick it in my clipboard part of my stamp tool that I've got here. And we're going to choose this largest jar. So I'll pull that off of there. Doesn't really matter where we stamp this because we're going to cut it out. When I've stamped this jar before, I have stamped it with Versamark and clear embossed the jar so that it looks more like glass. On this card, I just stamped in black and cut around it, and I think it looks fine like that, and it's one less step. So I'm just going to do that again. We're just going to stamp it with my Ranger Archival Jet Black. So I've got it where I want it on the page there. I'm going to pick it up and then ink up our stamp. And get it stamped down. That's the benefit of having a stamp tool. It didn't quite stamp very perfectly at the top of the jar, so I'm going to go ahead and ink that up again. Just ink the whole thing up and stamp it one more time. Okay, that looks really nice. And while it's in here, I'm going to take my baby wipe and clean my stamp off. And just remove that stamp. And then I'm going to go ahead and choose my fairy. Once again, the stamp set is something I purchased on eBay from China. And I want to say I paid, I don't know, less than a dollar for these stamps. So you can get some really great stamps on there. This has a lot of different fairies, some that are kind of swinging, some that are sitting on branches. So it's a pretty cute set. I'm choosing out of that set this fairy here. She's holding like a wand. So I am going to place her in my jar where I want her. And I'm trying to kind of place her where that wand will be kind of as much to the center of the jar as I can get it, just because it will help when we get to making the circuit. Okay, so I think that's a good spot for it. So I'm going to pick that up and go ahead and stamp that in the same Ranger Archival Black. And I'm going to go ahead and ink that up and do that one more time so it's a nice, good image. I don't know if you guys can hear that barking in the background. I'm dog sitting for a friend, and he's in the other room barking. All right, clean that off, and we'll put that stamp back. Okay, now that I've got everything on that I need stamped, I'm going to take it out of there. Just so I don't lose it, I'm going to put my sentiment stamp back in there, and we'll put that to the side. Okay, so now that I've got everything stamped on the jar, I am going to just take my scissors and trim that out. Okay, now that I've got it cut out, a trick that I learned, I'm not sure who I learned it from, many of you might already know this trick, but when you cut out an image, it really makes the image look more professional. If you take a black marker, I'm just going to use my Spectrum Noir Black, and just go around the edges of where you cut, because if you see right now, well, I don't know how well you can see, but it's white, of course, right now. And you can see, like, every little nick in that paper from cutting it. So I just trace around the edge of anything that I cut out with a black marker. You can use a Sharpie. This is just what I have handy. You could also use a black ink, so I could just take this and rub the edges on my archival black ink. I used to do that, and then I found that I could just do it with a marker, and it's much easier, and I don't have to wait for it to dry. So I just go all around the edge, and you'll see sometimes my pen slips onto the back, and we get a few black lines on the back, but it's the back, who cares? All right, so now that I've gone all around the edge, I'm going to look at the front and see if I still see any white that maybe I didn't get quite close enough to the black outline of the stamp. And I'm going to really carefully, so I don't slip on the front, just go and color that little bit of white in so it doesn't look like I miscut at all. Okay. So I am happy with that. Oh, no, I'm not. A little bit down here. Okay, now I'm happy with that. Now we're going to go in and color the jar to kind of match our background, like I have here, so it's like you can see through the jar. So that's where I'm using my little palette and my water brush. I have already put the colors on the palette, and I don't know that I will need any more than that. It's the same colors that I use for the background. Chipped Sapphire, Mermaid Lagoon, Seedless Preserves, Mowed Lawn, and Pine Needles. So it's all the same colors. Now, what I need to do, actually before we color this, is pull out the colored background and the grassy area, and kind of decide where I want that to be on the paper. Because like I said, I leave this grassy piece bigger so I can determine where I want this hill to lie on the background. So if we place it there and I put my card over, there's going to be a dip here. And so in the background, it's going to be down and then up. If I put it along this side, then I'm going to have to start with a raised area in the background and go down. So let's look one more time. I think I kind of like it this way with this card lined up here. So what we're going to do is we're just going to line this up here from edge to edge. And I'm just going to put this in my trimmer and trim this side off to be the length of that card. So like I said, this is 5 1/4 by 4. So 4 inches long is how long I want this. And I want this side cut off. So I'm going to flip this over so I've got a flat edge. You can't see that. So that I've got a flat edge against my trimmer. And I'm going to bring this down to 4. And then just slice that off. Okay. So now, when I line this up, it's the right size. And it shows me where my hill is going to be. So, I can't attach this yet because my circuit has to go under here. So I'm just going to line it up so that it's lined up perfectly there. And I'm going to place my jar where I want it on the page. I'm going to have my stamp right up here again. So I think I want my jar to lie right about there. Try to make it as straight as I can. But really, I think it's going to be right about there. So something else I didn't mention that you needed was a pencil. And of course I can't find my pencil. Here it is. Okay. So you're just going to take a pencil and really lightly, I'm just going to kind of trace this to match this grassy background here. Follow that hill. That way I'll know. Let me bring this up so you can see it. Can you see that faint pencil line there? That just follows the curve of this hill. That way I know, first of all, where to put that jar back on the page after I'm done coloring it. And also which side, like where to color the background and where to color the grass on the jar. Now, of course, I could have stamped this jar and fairy on watercolor cardstock or watercolor paper because I am going to be watercoloring on this. I chose not to simply because it doesn't stamp as well on watercolor paper because of that texture. So this is just plain white cardstock, 110 pound, and it will work fine for the water I'm going to put on it, so I'm not going to stress about that. Like I said, so just we're going to draw that line and then we can move those off to the side again. Okay, so now I'm going to take my water brush. I'm going to get the bristles kind of damp. And I'm going to start with the sky portion of the jar. I'm just going to pre-wet this piece of paper. Just starting at the very top of the page, because like I said in a previous video, probably, that it dries pretty quickly. So I'm going to wet that top part, and then I'm just going to dab into my sky colors and just kind of blot them onto the paper, just kind of randomly in that wet area. Just so I get kind of that same effect on the background. Now I'm going to go down and I'm going to add a little bit more water down further, all the way, in fact, to my pencil line. That's where my sky is going to end. And keep adding that color. Right to that line. Okay, this is what we're left with, where you can see that color the best, maybe about right there. That's what we're left with, and I'm going to go ahead and dry that. Now, because it's not watercolor paper, it did warp quite a bit more, but now, against the background, you can see it kind of matches. It's a bit lighter. I could go in with another layer of the watercolor, or of the inks if I need to. For now, I'm just going to move on to the grass. So again, well, first I'm going to squeeze that blue color out of my brush so that I'm not turning the grass blue. Okay, then I'm going to pre-wet this piece of paper, or this part of the paper, the whole thing. I'm going to dip into my greens and do the exact same thing. And then I'm just going to dry it. Okay. I'm going to pull out my background pieces and just kind of align everything where it will be on the final card. Okay. It's going to be about like that. Hopefully you can see those colors. See, that's pretty warped there. I think that it will be fine. I'm not going to go in and add any more color to the jar because my paper is already pretty warped, and I can see some of the fibers they're already kind of getting ruined. So I'm not going to add more water to this and potentially ruin it. Again, if it was watercolor paper, you could add quite a bit more water and it would be fine. I'm just going to leave it as it is. I think it looks fine. So, I am going to try to go in with an eraser, because I can still see a faint pencil line right here. And I'm just going to try to erase that pencil line. I don't want to rub too much, because again, that's agitating the fibers of the paper. I think it looks good. Okay, now we've pretty much got the basics of what we need before we add in the paper circuit portion. So again, I'm going to line up the papers where I need them. But first, I'm going to go in with, I've just got a thumbtack here. Simply because I don't have a paper piercer. If you had a paper piercer, use that for this. Right on her little wand here, you can see that there's a center point in where that light would be. I'm going to go ahead and poke this pin right through that center point, because that will let me know where on the back, if that makes sense. That will let me know where it comes out on the back. Okay? Then I'm going to go in with my Spectrum Noir yellow colors that I brought out, the FL3 and CT1. I'm going to start with the FL3 and just color as if this was, I think it's running out of ink, just color as if this was emitting some light here on all those little rays. Then I'm going to go in with my CT1 and just add a little bit of a darker spot right in the center. And once again, go in with my FL3 and just really saturate the paper because it helps that light shine through better when you get the LED underneath. It really shines through better when that paper is more saturated. Then I'm going to turn it over and I can see where that yellow is coming through. And I'm just going to go ahead and on the back, saturate that paper some more with that yellow, that FL3. Okay. So that's all I'm doing for her wand right now. Just making it yellow at the tip. Okay? Now we can go ahead and pull all of this back together, align the papers where we're going to use them. Right there. And bring out my pencil again. And I'm going to stick this pencil lead, holding this jar down where I want it. I'm going to stick the pencil lead through that hole that I created just so that I can make a dot on the background page where that hole will be. So you can't see it. I can see it. Right here is where I'm wanting that LED to go so that when I line this up on my background, it's right under her wand. Okay. Just gonna make sure I mark that so I can remember. All right, now we need to get out our battery. Our LED, like I said, this has a lot of LEDs in it, two sizes and multiple colors. I'm just going to choose the white, and I'm gonna choose the smaller of the two sizes I have. And I'm going to get out my copper tape. Okay, if you have not made a paper circuit before or don't know much about LEDs, the LED, like the battery, has two sides, a positive and a negative. I'm going to bring this up closer so you can see. Okay, maybe you can see. So this part of the battery is the positive side. Let's see if my light will shine on it better. There we go. This is the positive side of the battery. The underneath is the negative side. It's not marked, but the positive side is. On the LED itself, let's see what I can use. Maybe you can use this. You can kind of see that. One side, one prong is longer than the other. The long side is the positive side. So when you connect it to the battery, it's not going to be the LED straight to the battery like I'm showing you. You're going to connect it using the copper tape. But just so that I can show you how it lights up. The longer end, the longer prong of the LED is going to connect with the positive side of your battery. Okay, and that shorter side is going to connect with your shorter side. So that when you connect them, it turns on your light. Okay, just like that. So that is important to remember because it will not work if you do it the opposite way. It will not turn it on. Okay, so on our background. Now, I hope I didn't turn this over. Let me align this and make sure I did not turn this. That should still be right. Okay. I wanted to make sure that this was still the top of my card. Okay. So, we are going to draw out where we want our copper tape to go. I'm going to put the battery down here in this corner of the card. So, I'm just going to make a circle here just to remind me that this is where the battery is going to go. Okay. And I'm going to put a dash there to remind me that that's where the negative side of the battery is going to go. So the negative will rest right on top of that circle, leaving the positive side facing up. Okay, this is where my LED is going to go, where I made that mark earlier. And I know you can't see these pencil lines, but trust me, they're there, and you'll see everything when I put the copper tape down. So my LED is going to go right here where I've got this dot, and I'm going to have the negative side of the LED come out to the right here, but I don't want it to pass my jar. So when I've got this lined up where I want it, I'm going to go ahead and lay everything back down. When I have this lined up, just like it's going to be on the final card, I do not want my copper tape to stick out on the side of this jar. So, lining this up again where it goes, I'm just going to draw a really faint line right at the edge of this jar all the way down. This will help me remember exactly where to place the jar later, and it will also let me know my boundaries for my copper tape. Okay, so. And I'm going to go ahead and trace the top of this grass also so that I'll know where everything else can go. It will be covered and you will not be able to see it on the final card. Okay, so again, I know you cannot see it, but I can. My LED is going to go here, and my negative wire is going to come this way, but it's not going to pass this boundary I have here. So I'm going to draw a line out this way, and I'm going to put a dash above it for my negative sign, knowing so that I know that this will be the negative part of my circuit. And I'm going to make it turn right there to go along this boundary. And I'm going to have it go all the way down and turn again. And then one final turn to make it connect with this negative part of my battery. So my copper tape for this negative terminal is going to go to the right, down, to the right, and down so that it'll land where this battery is going to be. Okay? Now, that's only one half of the circuit. I also need the positive end. So the way I like to create kind of a switch so that when you squeeze the card, the light will turn on. I'm going to use a piece of scrap paper, and I'm just going to use one of the scraps from where I cut out the jar. I'm going to take my scissors and I'm just going to cut a strip of paper, and that's probably still going to be too big. Cut a strip of paper, a rectangle of paper, okay? And I'm going to fold that rectangle in half. And this doesn't have to be perfect. You're not going to see it. It will be hidden. Okay? I'm going to cut that and fold it in half, okay, so that it can open and close. I am going to place that over where I said my battery was going to go on the card. Okay, and so I'm just going to kind of retrace that circle right on top of that and retrace that line where I said my negative piece of that copper tape is going to come through. Now you can maybe kind of see what I've got going on there. I've got a circle with a negative sign, and then you can see just the top of that pencil mark coming up, so that's where my copper tape is going to go. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and stick that down. I'm just going to use a little bit of ATG and stick that right in that corner. Okay. Okay, now you can see it opens and closes like a book. Okay, that's what we want. So, again, taking my pencil, there is also going to be a positive side coming out from this LED. So I'm going to take from this spot where I said the LED is going to be, I'm going to draw another line out. This one's going to come out to the left, and it's going to go down. And, of course, I want to make sure it's not going to go outside of the jar, but it won't. I haven't drawn it over that far. So I'm going to draw this line all the way down. I'm going to close this little book here. Draw this all the way down so that it's about at the center of this book, and I'm going to turn right, and I'm going to draw this right on top of my little book here. Okay. I'm going to open the book, and I'm going to continue that straight over, just to about the middle of that book. Okay, if that makes sense. So let's see. There's the open book. If I close it, it would still follow all the way around. Okay? This will make more sense once I've got the copper tape on there, and you can actually see what I'm doing. Okay, so speaking of, I'm going to find the end of my copper tape, which I secured with some washi. I'm going to, I need to remember, again, which prong on this LED is longer, because that's the positive side. So I'm going to spread these apart because that LED is going to lay flat on my piece of paper. Okay, so right now I've got the positive side, the longer side, longer prong, pointing to the left, and the shorter prong pointing to the right, just like I've got it drawn out on my page. I'm going to set that LED right in the little circle where I drew it through the jar, because that's where I want that LED to be. I'm going to set that LED right on that circle, and I'm going to get some copper tape. Now, here's what I'm going to do, because it's a pain to try to deal with the whole copper tape roll. I'm just going to, with my fingers, get a length of it and just tear it off. And then I'm going to peel some of the backing off, but not all of it, because it will curl up on you and be useless. You will have to throw it away. So I'm just going to peel just the tip of that copper tape off of the backing. And right on top of that negative end of the LED, I'm going to put that copper tape so that it's holding that prong down. Let me bring it up so you can see. Okay, so here's the LED, and that copper tape is holding that prong that's coming out to the right down on the page. I'm going to pull more of this backer off, and I'm going to kind of fold, in order to get a right angle on the copper tape, fold it in the opposite direction you want to go. So see how I pulled that copper tape up, straight up, and I'm just going to kind of press it down, and then I'm going to pull it in the way I do want to go, following my pencil lines that I made earlier, and bring it down to where I need to make another right angle. And then again, I'm going to pull it in the opposite direction of which I want to go and push it down, and then pull it the direction I do want to go. Okay, again, following where I already had my pencil line. And one more right turn we need to make right here. Fold it in the opposite direction I want to go, and then pull it down right till it gets to the center of that battery. Okay. And yes, I have extra copper tape, and that's fine. I'm just going to tear it off. Okay, so here's what we got. That's one side. That's the negative side. Okay, so it's following from the negative end of the LED all the way to where my negative end of my battery is going to be. Okay, now I'm going to take... That piece of copper tape is not going to be long enough to finish, so I will save that for another project, and I'm just going to tear off another piece. Okay, so I've got another piece of copper tape. I'm going to do the exact same thing. Tear off just a little piece of it. Attach it to the positive side this time of my LED. Now it needs to go at a right angle again. Follow my pencil line. Now, we're going to about to turn and go towards this little book thing here. So I'm going to close that book, follow my pencil line, and make a right angle here. Fold it in the opposite direction I want to go, and then fold it in the direction I want to go. I'm going to go right over the top of that book. Okay, and then I'm going to open the book. The tape is still attached. And I'm going to fold it over the side of that little book, just toward the end of my pencil line, right about that middle of that book cover, and tear it off. So, now let me show you again. This is the positive side we have coming out, okay? It's coming down, it made a right turn, it's over the top of the book, and it rounds the corner and goes to the inside of the book, okay? Because now, when we put our battery on there, remember, positive side facing up, and we close that book, it connects the two sides, and it turns on our light, okay? So that's going to be our button. Oh, and my battery fell. So that's going to be our button, okay, when we put together the whole card. All right, now putting it together. We're going to set that battery. The way that I make it so that you have to push so that it's not constantly connected, those two terminals, is with foam tape and foam squares, okay? I actually have these itty-bitty foam squares here. They're tiny. That's what I'm going to use, and I'm going to find a spot where the battery works really well. It's working great right there. I'm going to take... It's my doorbell again. I'm going to take a foam square off, and I'm going to put one on every side of this battery here. It will hold the battery in place, and it will make it so that you have to push right over the top of this in order to get that those terminals to connect, okay? So it will create a cushion so that when this is all taped down, it won't be connected unless you actually push it together, okay? So again, take a foam square, and you can put the foam square right over the copper tape. It's not going to hurt anything on this side here because it's connecting to the battery on the bottom, okay? So can you see how there I've got three little foam squares that are holding that battery in place? And I'm gonna go ahead and add more. Just because I won't be able to add a whole foam square here later to pop up this grass. Because this area is going to be popped up, we have to pop up the whole area that's going to be under the grass so that it's evenly raised. Okay. Add probably two more here. Now, you'll notice I keep testing that battery to make sure it's still working. Because I don't want to get it in a spot where it's not going to work when I build the card. See right there? I'm pushing. Oh, it's working, but it's not working every time I push. So, I might back up one of these foam squares a little bit so that battery can be in a spot where it works better. Okay, it's working really well right there. So I'm going to make sure that when I put my foam squares, it secures it in that spot that works really well for the battery. And that's not it. A lot of times I will go in on this copper tape and I'll use the back of my fingernail here and I will just kind of drive it along this copper tape to make sure it's nice and flat and that it's on these connectors really well. And that, see how it wasn't working just a second ago, and just because I did that, it works better now. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and take off the backers on all of these little foam squares. And then I'm going to close that book. Now, because those are double-sided foam squares, that book attaches nicely right on top of them, and when I push it, it makes the connection. Okay. Now, like I said, this whole part where this grass is going to be has to be popped up. Okay? So that's what I'm going to use these other foam squares for. Is just... And if you'll remember, I kind of created a pencil line to trace where that grass would be, so that I would know where to put my foam squares, because I want them to be hidden, obviously. And now, if you don't like using foam squares because you have to use a lot of them, and you would rather use foam tape, by all means, use your preferred method of pop dots. This I just find easier. The foam tape I'm using, I got on eBay, also from China, and I don't love it. It is really sticky, and I won't order it again, but I've got a lot of it, so I am using it for now. Okay, I've got a spot in here where I think it could use some of these small pop dot foam square things, so I'm just going to stick some of those on there too. Okay, now before I take off those backers, I'm going to put that grassy area on there, just to make sure that it will be fully covered with pop dots. And then I'm going to take the backers off. And again, I'm still going to kind of every once in a while test that light to make sure that I haven't messed anything up before I completely put the card together. Okay, I think I've got them all off. So now I'm going to carefully line up my grassy hill with the card, and so that's what we're left with. That little LED still sticks out the top, and when I press in the corner, it still lights up. Perfect. Okay, now the jar. And again, this is not watercolor paper, and so it is pretty warped. So if you want to, you know, put it in your die cutting machine and press it between the two plates to get it straight, or set it in a book overnight or something, feel free to do that. I'm not going to fuss with it. I'm just going to deal with it. So, if you'll notice, if we look at the side of the card, that LED right here sticks up a little bit further than our raised grassy area, okay? So when we put our jar on there, if we just put it flush with the grassy area, there's gonna be a lump where it hits that LED. So we need to pop the jar up for the part that's gonna be on the sky background. We need to pop it up with like two layers of foam tape, and the bottom where it's already popped up on the grass, we just need to do one layer. And you know what? I did not put any adhesive on the top of that book, and so it's not staying. I just had the foam dots, and I didn't have anything on, right on top of where we have that. So I'm just going to add a little bit of ATG right to the top of that, so that will stay down. Okay. So we're going to have to do, basically, we're going to have to do the jar in two parts. The top part with two layers of foam, and the bottom part with only one layer of foam, because we don't need two layers because the grass is already popped up, okay? So this is where I'm going to use my foam tape that I don't love. Just because it would be hard to get the exact shape of the jar with the squares. It's not easy to do it with this either, but it's a little bit easier maybe. So I am going to add this foam tape, and I already have ruined scissors with this too, because I don't have nonstick scissors. So I'm going to get my gunked up, ugh, nasty scissors ready for cutting this foam tape. Another important thing, don't put foam tape over this yellow spot or you will not see the LED through it. We're just going to put foam tape around the edges of this jar. If you guys have any recommendations for better foam tape, please leave them in the comments, because once I'm done with this, like I said, I'm not ordering it again. Look at that. Disgusting. And yes, I also know that they make nonstick scissors that would probably help me at least a little bit. Okay, I'm also going to add a strip of this in the middle. Like I said, we're going around the edges, but I'm going to put just one little strip down here below that yellow light. Okay. Now, we've got to pull the backer off of these and add another layer just to that top half. Okay. I'm going to kind of lift this up and see if I can use my light to see through to where I need to add a second layer. And I'm going to use my pencil, and I know you can't tell what I'm doing. I'm just looking through at the color, and I'm using my pencil to kind of draw along, again, the shape of that grass so that I'll know where I need to put the foam tape above for my extra layer on the sky. Okay, so on all of these pieces that are up here, above my pencil mark, I'm gonna stick more foam tape on top of the foam tape that we already have. Okay, yuck. Oh, this still isn't staying down. I'm gonna push that really hard. Okay. Before I take those backers off, I'm just going to light up my light and lay this kind of over so that I can make sure I'm getting it lined up with that yellow over the light. I don't know how well you can see that. Let me turn down my desk light here. That probably makes it easier for you to see the whole thing anyway. Okay, so if I turn on my light and then I lay this over it, I want that light to be under, there we go. I want that light to be under where it's yellow on my fairy. Okay. Okay, and it looks like it's all going to line up just fine. So I'm going to go ahead and take those backers off. Guys, if I would have known, I could have just turned down the brightness of my light and you would have been able to see better this whole time. I would have started like that. I apologize. It is nighttime here. It's about 9 o'clock, so I had my light all the way up on the brightest setting, thinking that would help, because there's no daylight. Okay, so here's my sticky mess on the back, space for that, where that LED is going to go. gotta light up my LED so that I know where to place my card or where to place my jar. Oh, and it's being finicky with me. Okay, so right about there. And at the same time I'm looking at the light, I'm also, and you can actually touch to make sure that LED's under there. I'm also looking at the grass to make sure the hills kind of line up and making sure my jar is straight on the page. Ooh, I went to set it down there and you can see here, you can see that copper tape. So I'm gonna go ahead and lift it up while I still can and scoot it over just a little bit more to the right. I really don't wanna see that copper tape. So it's not really where I originally planned, but it's close enough. And it's covering up a little bit more of that copper tape here. Okay. I'm gonna push it all down. Okay. Now, before I stamp the sentiment in the corner, I am going to go ahead and attach this to my card base because it will help eliminate some of that warped, because the paper is a little bit warped from the watercolor. So once we attach it to this flat cardstock, it makes it a little bit flatter and it'll be a better stamping surface. Okay. Again, I'm just going to use my ATG to attach that. And you could attach it to the card base before you put all that foam on there if you have a hard time running the ATG on an uneven surface. It doesn't bother me to do it, so I just do this last. Okay, fair amount of ATG so that it doesn't come off. Make sure your card is going in the right direction. Line it up. Still works. Probably can't see that as well anymore. Okay. And now is when I'm going to stamp that sentiment. Again, I'm going to use my stamp tool that I made. If I can find where I put it. Here it is. I've got all kinds of washi tape and post-it tape in here because that's what I use to hold down most of my pieces of paper. Okay, so I'm going to use my post-it tape and I am just going to tape along these edges that I have here of the actual card base and just stick it down so that it'll be nice and flat. And then I'm going to align my sentiment where I want it. It's got some fuzz. And I'm going to try to make sure that's as straight as I can get it. I noticed on my other one it wasn't very straight. I wonder if we could put this down here, if it would fit. And then you could push where the sentiment was, and it would light up. Let's try that. I would have thought of that at first. I would have moved the jar over a little bit more, but let's just try it a little bit different. Let's put that sentiment right there so that when you push on the sentiment is when it lights up. It just barely fits, but we'll try it. Okay, I'm gonna pick that up. Hopefully it doesn't stamp funky because that's raised. I'm just winging it. Okay. Ink this up. Press it down. And again, because it's watercolor paper, and it's textured, that ink doesn't really want to stamp very well the first time. So that's the benefit of doing it in a stamp tool. Ink it up again and lay it back on top. That's not bad. I like that. I'm going to do it one more time just because I see a couple areas that didn't get inked. And then we'll call it good. Okay, so I'm going to pick up that post-it tape. We'll clean off my stamp. Okay, this is what we've got. Brighter, wishing you brighter days to come. And so when you push on the sentiment, it lights up the card. turn down my light even more here. Maybe you can see. There we go. Can you see that when I push it? That's super cool, guys. Actually, before I go, one more thing. On this card, the only other thing I added was to that yellow area on the end of her wand. You can see that little bit of sparkle, maybe. Let me turn my light back up. You can see maybe some of that sparkle. I just added some Wink of Stella there to the end. So, all right. That's it. Thanks for watching. Again, this is Jasmine with Jazzy Crafts and Cards.